under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in the time of this pleasure. So that simply means that the mysteries of this present life are the test to which God puts his own children. He passes judgment upon them. He classifies them according to the degree of courage that they have shown. So we all have our share of suffering. And suffering simply comes because we are struggling against our enemies. And the day is not far off when the judge will pass sentence on the merits of each one of us and reward each to the recompense that he has won. So right now is the time to struggle. As the book of Job says, life in this earth is a time of war. So now is the struggle, later the rest and the crown. So happy are those who during these days of probation have recognized the mighty hand of God in all the trials they have had and have humbled themselves under its pressure, lovingly and confidently. Against such Catholics who have been strong in the faith, the roaring lion has not been able to prevail. Now many people nowadays are not able to recognize the hand of God in their lives. And so they suffer either from depression, anxiety, frustration. But the thing, the truth is that most of our anxieties or frustration have a relationship to time. You know, some of us have a great ability to unite the past to the present by memory and the future to the present by imagination. So all our unhappiness comes from excessive concentration either on the past or from extreme preoccupation with the future. So we don't have the time, nor the effort, the courage to humble ourselves under the mighty hand of God. But God, in his mercy, has given us two remedies for such an unhappiness. One is the sacrament of penance, which blots out the past by remission of our sins. It lightens up the future by a hope of divine mercy through our continued repentance and amendment of our lives. So the sacrament of penance is the first remedy. And the second remedy is what we call the sanctification of the present moment. That simply means that each day has its own trials. So that means that we cannot borrow troubles from tomorrow, because tomorrow is going to have its own. We are to leave the past to divine mercy and the future to divine providence. So each moment of our lives has its peculiar duty, regardless of the period that moment may take. The present moment has things over which we have control, and has also things and difficulties which we cannot avoid. And you know which one they are. So those who love God do not complain. A sick person, for example, takes medicine without demanding an explanation for the bitter taste of the medicine. And we know that God knows what is the best for us at each determined moment. But we don't put that into practice. So those who accept God's will in all things always escape frustration or anxiety or depression. Because it is, you know, strange how differently we accept misfortune when we know who gave it to us. Accepting the crosses of our own state of life because they come from God is to have taken the most important step in the reformation of the world, that is, the reformation of ourselves. To accept the duty of each moment for God is like to touch eternity. It's like to escape from time. That is why St. Peter says, be humbled under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in the time of visitation, casting all your cares upon him, for he cares about you. So, we don't need to have an intellectual knowledge of God's plan for every day in order to accept whatever happens every specific day. For example, when St. Paul was converted, the only thing he asked our Lord was, Lord, what do you want me to do? The good thief and the bad thief on the cross had the same crisis of fear and suffering. One of them complained, and so he lost the chance for heaven, but the other sanctified the moment of suffering. St. Paul says, all things work for the good of those who love God. So we might be tempted to make our own crosses, but since our Lord didn't make his own, neither do we make ours. We can take whatever God gives us, and we can make the supernatural best of it. Every task, every difficulty, every duty can be ennobled and spiritualized if it is done for God's greater glory and honor, our own sanctification, and the salvation of our souls.